What's up, Star Family? Today's video, I'm so excited to be making. So good to be making videos again. Okay. It's only been like what, 2 weeks or something? But it feels like a long time when like your days are like lifetimes within lifetimes. It's like 2 weeks can feel like a long time, right? So today's video, I was inspired to make about, one of the ways that we can confirm, or just like a fun phenomenon that tends to happen within soul family groups. First of all, you guys probably know people like soul family when you meet them. It's just like this instant connection. You just resonate with them. It's like you guys have, it's almost like it feels like you're meeting an old friend for the first time. I'm sure many of you guys already know, like, kind of the mechanisms behind that, what that feels like. So, that's not what I was getting into so much as just a fun phenomenon that seems to happen. And, one of the things that makes a soul family group what it is, again, I've used this analogy before when breaking down the twin flame slash split soul kind of dynamic. Like, you can think of it like a tree. Right, and soul family shares this will be fun learning how to break down multi-dimensional concepts. Soul family, you exhibit similar ways of being and you think the same way. You share very similar lenses of perception, right? And there's this deep just recognition, like you feel like this person is your family. You feel like they're not separate from you. It's because they're on that same tree, right? Essentially, what soul groups are beings that A have kind of expanded their lens of perception to include more actuality, or to include more of the nature of reality, right? And so certain soul groups will incarnate to kind of do that work together. So we're aware that this is an individual experience, but it's not very much individual. We all come in to whatever time period we come into and incarnate on Earth, and we learn certain things, right? And we explore certain things as an individual. But also, like, where this collective thing ties into is we come in, and depending on where the planet is at and its levels of awareness, will also influence our own individual experience, right? So that's kind of where this notion of karma, like personal karma or individual karma, it doesn't really matter if you think it's yours or if you think it's not, or how much you think of what you're exploring is for you and how much what you think you're exploring is for other people, because at the end of the day, this is like a collective thing, right? And so we're inevitably, the time period that we incarnate on and the things that we're exploring, our hangups, our insecurities, etc., is all going to be influenced by the state of the collective, right? And then, soul family are beings that there's two things that are coming through right now. So there are certain beings that we have simply just made a contract with within this incarnation specifically. So certain soul groups might have a contract to, let's all, beings that have never incarnated on Earth before, let's all go to Earth at this time, right? And then you can have contracts with other beings that are not necessarily part of that soul group, but that are essential for, like, you've made a contract with them within this incarnation to provide a certain learn teach type of framework dynamic for, right? So generally the notion of soul groups are beings that we just have gone through this ascension process with, and or that we are currently going through this process of ascension with. And so essentially what ascension is removing the veils and merging closer. Not that you can go anywhere, right? But you're removing veils, so it appears and it feels like you have developed a deeper connection or a closer connection with the source of all. And so before I blabber too much about that, I just wanted to lay groundwork of my interpretation of soul group and soul family members. I mean, this has even been studied within like reincarnation and people that do like past life regression therapies and that have, studied this for a long time. It's very known that certain groups or certain higher selves will choose to work together for this shared learn teaching process in order to walk each other home, as Ram Dass would say. Like, he's sitting right here next to me. I guess he kind of is. He is sitting right next to me. So one of the fun ways that this will happen, and this is, I guess, kind of a story time video, is like you'll notice that it doesn't matter how long you go without talking to someone that you know is soul family or part of your soul group, or that it just feels like, regardless if you know or not, it just feels like you guys are just at the same place, or that you guys just get each other. You don't need to explain yourself overly or anything. It's like you can just like completely appear authentically and without having to overly explain yourself, right? So you'll notice that they seem to go through similar explorations in their own way, but at a similar time. It's almost like you can be on opposite ends of the planet, but still be receiving the same type of downloads and the same type of realizations. And there's different things happening. First of all, when you're connected to your soul family and when you're connected to this tree, it's like anything that you're learning will then be upgraded to the astral realms. Or another way of saying that is to the Akash, right? And so you guys are connected by this information of this tree trunk, right? And so when one version of you or one aspect of your soul family is expanding and learning things, that's actually being uploaded to the astral realms or to the Akash, right? And again, it's not like the rest of humanity, the whole of humanity is not also being influenced by that, but it's a lot more rapid. There's a lot less time between, it's almost like an instantaneous thing when this information is being sent back up to this tree trunk, right, of your soul group, of your soul family. It's so funny because recently I had a soul brother, like, okay, how am I gonna get into this? So I had a friend recently who he shared something about how he's been feeling lonely and he's been feeling like he's a very, very advanced soul. He's like one of the most beautiful beings I have ever met in this lifetime. And I don't think you would mind me using him as an example, but he has actually been on my channel before, Puya. I've done a collaboration with him before. And we've been talking a lot. We'll go through periods of not talking very much and then talking a lot, which is like very, very also just like normal or common for soul family members too. It's like you don't always have to be talking in the 3D to know that you're connected and to know that, like, yeah, it just works differently with soul family. He posted something on Facebook. He shared something on Facebook about him feeling very lonely and then really going deep into the sense of loneliness because he, you know, lonely in terms of like wanting a counterpart type of dynamic, like a romantic counterpart type of dynamic. And he was saying how he started feeling the loneliness and he was looking around and he saw everyone with their significant others and everyone seemed like so blissed and so just like connected and how he wanted that. And then he really started diving into the feeling behind it. And essentially through looking into it, diving into it, he was able to transcend that feeling. And he was feeling good and he was feeling connected to source and more connected to his higher self, which ultimately is what we tend to feel more of, at least in the beginning of these romantic counterpart dynamics, which is why people can just want to be in relationships so much, is because they're seeking that high that you get from having veils removed in terms of how much you're able to open your heart and how in love you are in general with life, right? We can tend to become very addicted to that process. And so he did the process, he did the work of remembering what's true, of coming back to the truth of things and coming back to his center. And he got up, left the park, and he said he ended up running into a woman who was reading a book on a bench about depression and loneliness. And so he said something about the book and he said, "Do you feel that?" And she said, "Kinda." And he said, "Just kinda." And I guess they started laughing and lo and behold, they ended up talking for like an hour. And he said it was like time didn't exist and it was so perfect. It was so weird that he just had that experience. And then after letting go, he had come into this, you know, situation where there he was in front of a beautiful woman and he got to experience a glimpse of that timeline of being in that type of dynamic, right? And so funny because I had just been reading that same thing this exact day. I had read that thing on Facebook and I also had that experience earlier that week. Like I saw some people in my family, like with all their partners, with their romantic partners. And I felt that, like, I don't feel this too often because I'm Virgo. I'm okay being on my own. I'm like the high priestess, right? One in and of herself. So I don't normally long very much for romantic dynamics because for me, it just seems to work out where, like, if it's going to happen, it's going to happen and I can't force it. I'm not on dating sites or anything. I'd much rather meet you in person, right? And so I was just feeling that sense of like, I noticed I was feeling that sense of like jealousy almost and just like, damn, like that would be really nice to even just like remember what that's like again. And that happened earlier the week. And then I was at the park with my daughter and I had read Puya's post and I thought, oh my God, how beautiful. Like, that's exactly kind of what I'm going through. And I kid you not, it was so interesting because I had met someone, or I had seen someone at the park that day that I was like instantly attracted to. And I was like, wow, he's very handsome. He had a daughter. So normally I assume that, like, these guys, I assume guys that are very attractive with kids, like, are married or something or already taken. I don't know why, but they're instantly like, I'm not even thinking of them in that way, but I remember I kept being drawn to him and I could feel, your girl is tuned in. So I could like feel a mutual kind of curiosity. And I had just read that post. I had also just gone through the process of letting go and being like, okay, I don't need to stress about it. What's meant for me, it won't pass me by, kind of thing. And then, long story short, this guy makes his way over to my world, or to where I was sitting. My world, where I was sitting on the grass, and we ended up talking for 4 hours, like 4 hours at the park. And it was like time did not exist, and everything Puya had just talked about, I was experiencing. And I was like, what the F? Like, I was just liking his post like 5 minutes before this dude walked over and like introduced himself and we started talking. And it was crazy. And it was like we had known each other for so long, right? So there's many multidimensional layers to this. Right, there's different aspects to this whole soul family thing that I feel like I might not be able to get into in just one video. But I do want to say that coming back to the point of this video is like it is so beautiful. Like, it is just such a wonderful complement to what soul family is here to do, because Puya and I've been talking a lot back and forth about, relationships now, because we're both in this space of like being very empowered within ourselves, but it's like I want to share this with someone else. And then going through that, being activated towards that direction of finding or just of like exploring that potential with other people, and then getting glimpses of what that might feel like, what it might feel like to be with someone who kind of speaks your same language. Because at least for me, for the most part, I don't meet too many guys that are up to speed with where I feel like I'm at. And this is going to sound however it's going to sound, but I feel like most divine feminines that I know kind of are in the same boat. And so when I do stumble across that, I'm very surprised. Also, when there is like kind of a sexual attraction as well. And so it's interesting because like soul family is there to support. Like, it was, even though we can both know conceptually and we can give the other really great advice and feedback, it's like soul family is there to kind of hold the torch for you when you are exploring something similar. So not only is soul family kind of already at where you're at, your higher selves are connected, right? Your higher selves have intended for this dynamic to be reflective of each other. So it's like you're kind of already at the same place, so to speak, within understanding the multidimensional nature of things, even if you can't conceptualize it, just like intuitively feeling that. But it's like soul family will hold the torch for you, right? And so that reinforces for them what they know to be true. So then it helps them, right, this other individual, navigate their experiences more, because then they're helping you through it, right? Because even though sometimes we can know better, but then we understand conceptually, but then there comes the work of applying what it is we know to be true to the situation outside, right? That's why I call this a university, because it's like you learn, you understand, you conceptualize, you're getting downloads, you're getting guidance from your teachers or your guides, whatever. And then now comes the real life application process when you are getting an opportunity to actually apply what it is you've learned and to see how much or how less those karmic knots have undone themselves, right? And so that's such a beautiful part of soul family, is you really do get to support each other through things, but that support reinforces everyone involved, right? And so it's become this beautiful thing. We've been talking so much and sending memes and just really, I've developed such a deeper understanding of this whole thing. Because then whether or not this relationship is going to go anywhere, right? Not talking about this, my situation, but this is just using this as an example, because then you have soul family like reinforcing things for you. And also, oh yeah, Dirty Zen. Got a shout out to Dirty Zen too, because I've been talking to Landon, who makes awesome mixes on Dirty Zen. I'll link both their channels below, but it's like soul family, it's so beautiful because you can get to the bottom of things, or you can Like, soul family won't let leave you feeling worse about things. Like, so often I've found myself in situations where people just didn't speak my language, and so I felt a lot worse because they weren't seeing the angle I was coming from, right? They were seeing through a more narrow lens than I was, and so I was usually left feeling worse, right? Truth and expanding your levels of awareness will always make you feel better, right? It brings you closer to the truth of things, and so that feels good, like you can breathe. And so when you meet aspects of soul family members, it's like it feels better because, again, their levels of perception is in the same realms as your own. So it's been such a beautiful, just it's so beautiful. I just can't stop saying beautiful because it's so beautiful. But yeah, I think I pretty much touched on everything that I wanted to talk about in this video. It's been, man, you guys, I got some updates for you, so be prepared. These videos are gonna be rolling out. There's a lot I've been exploring and been wanting to talk about. So yeah, let me know what you guys think of, if anything was sparked up for you during this video. Please leave a comment. I love connecting with you guys in the comments, and I hope I see you soon.